Geographic Update Partnership Software, or GUPS 3, Reviewing and Updating Boundaries. This video will cover BAS Submission Guidelines, explore the BAS Toolbar and GUPS, and demonstrate how to use GUPS to review existing boundary data, create boundary changes, and update linear features. Through BAS, participants may record legal changes, such as annexations, de-annexations, incorporations, and disincorporations. They may also make boundary corrections and make updates to linear features and point and area landmarks. For all reported legal changes, including annexations, de-annexations, incorporations, and disincorporations, the user must provide legal boundary change information, such as the change type, effective date, authorization type, documentation numbers, and the area in acres. The change type and the area fields are automatically populated when using GUPS to report a legal change. Boundary corrections are adjustments to inaccurate boundaries due to spatial misalignments. These types of changes do not require any legal action or documentation. To aid users in creating their BAS submission, GUPS provides a BAS toolbar containing BAS-specific functions necessary for completing all review and update activities and exporting zipped shapefiles. To create a BAS submission, open the working county and make sure all desired layers are turned on. GUPS will automatically turn on the most relevant layers for the working county, such as roads and current places. To increase accuracy of boundary and feature updates, use the Add Imagery tool to add satellite imagery onto the map. To review legal boundaries, users should import their local boundary shapefile or other reference data, such as a street centerline dataset or parcels layer, using the Add Vector Layer button on the Manage Layers toolbar. They should use their local boundary data to review against the U.S. Census Bureau boundary data for their government. Zoom and pan through the map view, looking for areas where the Census Bureau's boundary data is inconsistent with local government boundary data, whether due to an unreported legal change or a boundary inaccuracy. Shown here is an example of where the local boundary data does not match the Census Bureau shapefiles. To report an annexation or de-annexation, select the Modify Area Feature tool on the BAS toolbar. Then, select the entity type from the Geography field drop-down menu. Next, select the entity name for the annexation. In GUPS, the working county is built on individual polygons displayed on the map. To select the faces to add or remove, use the Select Features button on the Dialog Box toolbar. The default selection tool, Select Features, allows users to draw a window that selects all features within that window. To select a single face, simply drag the cursor outward in the center of the face or left-click the face itself. To select multiple faces, drag the cursor along the edges that separate the faces. For other methods of selection, please refer to the BAS GUPS Respondent Guide. Because all geographic areas consist of one or more faces, one may need to split a face for an accurate reflection of the local government boundary. To correct the boundary in these areas, users will first create new boundary lines using the Add Linear Feature tool. To get started, select the Add Linear Feature tool on the BAS toolbar. Left-click the mouse at the starting point of the line and continue to left-click the mouse at each vertex point of the line. When the new line is complete, right-click the mouse. The right-click tells GUPS to finish drawing. Make sure the new feature snaps to both ends to ensure creation of two separate faces. The default snapping tolerance is 15 pixels. Use the instructions in Table 11 of the BAS GUPS Respondent Guide to change the tolerance. In the MTFCC field drop-down menu, choose the appropriate code for the feature. The code for a non-visible legal boundary is P0001. Leave the name field blank and select OK. The new face created by adding the linear feature can now be selected and either added to or removed from the government. To report an annexation, refer to the Modify Area feature tool and select Add Area. The Modify Area feature Choose Change Type pop-up box appears and asks the user to choose a change type. Select Legal Change, then select OK. Select the calendar icon next to the EFF date field to open the calendar and then choose the effective date for the boundary change. Select an authorization type for the change in the Auth Type field drop-down menu. In the Docu field, type in the ordinance or other legal documentation number authorizing the boundary change or upload documentation for the change. To upload documentation, select the folder icon next to the Docu field. Finally, select Annexation in the drop-down menu for the Change Type field and select OK when finished. The added faces change color on the map to denote the change. To report a de-annexation, follow the same process. Instead of selecting the Add Area tool, users should select the Remove Area tool and select de-annexation for the change type. If during their review, the user found a legal boundary that is incorrectly located but is not the result of a legal change, they should follow the steps to report an annexation or de-annexation, but should select Boundary Correction as the change type instead of Legal Change and select OK. Boundary corrections do not require supporting documentation or an effective date. To create a boundary change that crosses a county boundary, users must first change the working county to the county containing the faces to add. To switch the working county, save the current project, then select Map Management on the standard toolbar. To change the working county, open the drop-down menu next to the Working County field and select the new working county from the list. Select County in the Entity Type field. Within the list of adjacent counties, unselect all counties except the original working county. Then select Open at the bottom of the Map Management dialog box. The new map view displays both the old and new working counties, and the Layers panel displays the layers for all loaded counties. To add area to the old working county from within the new working county, select the Modify Area feature tool on the BAS toolbar. In the Geography field drop-down menu, select the government type to assign the annexed land to. Scroll down the list and select the row for the correct government. Zoom in to the faces to be annexed and select the Select Features tool on the dialog box toolbar. Left-click the face or faces on the map to be added. To add the faces selected within the new working county to the government, select the Add Area button on the dialog box toolbar. For legal changes, choose the change type, provide the required information, and select OK. For boundary corrections, select Boundary Correction, then select OK. If a change involves a county or state boundary correction, the governments affected will be contacted to verify these corrections. To add an incorporation, select the Modify Area feature tool on the BAS toolbar. Select the type of government to add from the Geography field drop-down menu. Zoom to the location of the new incorporation. Use the Select Features tool on the dialog box toolbar to select the faces for the new incorporation. To record the new incorporation, select Add Entity on the dialog box toolbar. In the New Entity dialog box, type the government name in the Name field and choose the entity type in the LSAD drop-down menu. Next, add the effective date, legal documentation or legal document number, and the authorization type and select OK. If the new incorporation crosses a county boundary, it must be added in both counties separately. After making the change in the working county, open the Map Management window, select the other county as the working county, and proceed to add the new incorporation in this county as well. If the new incorporation crosses more than one county boundary, complete the addition in each county affected. To complete the dissolution of a government, follow the same steps as a new incorporation. Instead of selecting the Add Entity button, users should select Delete Entity on the dialog box toolbar. Users are also able to make updates to existing linear features. To add a linear feature, first zoom to the location of the map to add the feature to, then select the Add Linear Feature tool on the BAS toolbar. Left-click the mouse at the starting point of the line and continue to left-click the mouse at each vertex point of the line. When the new line is complete, right-click the mouse to finish drawing. The Add Linear Feature dialog box opens. In the MTFCC field drop-down menu, choose the appropriate code for the feature. The street codes begin with S. Then, type the name of the linear feature in the name field. When entering the feature name, be sure to either spell out the feature type, such as road, avenue, and street, or select an approved abbreviation from the list provided in Appendix D of the BAS GUPS Respondent Guide. Select OK when finished. The added linear feature and the name assigned appear on the map. For a complete list of MTFCC codes and descriptions, refer to Appendix C in the BAS GUPS Respondent Guide. To delete an existing linear feature, zoom to the location on the map to delete the feature from, then select the Delete Restore Linear Feature tool on the BAS toolbar. Left-click the linear feature to delete. The selected linear feature will highlight and the Delete Linear Feature pop-up box appears, asking for confirmation to delete the feature. Select OK to delete the feature. The highlight is removed and the feature now appears with X's through it. If the linear feature was deleted in error, left-click the deleted feature. The Delete Linear Feature dialog box opens, this time asking for confirmation to restore the linear feature. Select OK. The Delete Line flag disappears from the attribute table, and the feature is restored. If no other edits have been made, the user can alternatively use the Undo button in the standard toolbar. To update a linear feature's attributes, select the Modify Linear Feature Attributes tool on the BAS toolbar. Then, select the linear feature to update on the map. To update the name of the feature, update the Full Name field. If correcting the MTFCC, select the down arrow to the right of the field to open the drop-down menu, and select the correct MTFCC from the menu. To change the address range for the linear feature, type in potential address ranges in the L2Add, R2Add, LFromAdd, and RFromAdd fields based on the directional arrows. When finished, select Save in the Modify Linear Feature Attributes dialog box. For assistance using GUPS to create a BAS submission, refer to the BAS GUPS Respondent Guide. Chapter 2 provides information on reviewing existing BAS data. Chapter 5 provides information on the basic functionality of GUPS. And Chapter 6 provides step-by-step instructions for reviewing features and making BAS updates in GUPS. For additional information and for BAS support, please contact the Census Bureau by phone toll-free at 1-800-972-5651 or by email at geo.bas@census.gov. Participants may also refer to the BAS website for resources.